this is from the 2017 task 2, the CSED 2604, question 2.3. The first thing you need to do when you see a question like this is a standard truss. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 loads on here. One is in UDL, so it's 5 kN/m for a total distance of 4 meters. So each span here is for 4 meters, so 2 meter intervals. And your height here is also 2 meters. So that means that this is a 45-degree angle. So if you need to solve this, the first thing you need to do in the recipe is to calculate your reactions. So we've got two reactions, one on the side here and one on the right hand side. So we've got reaction A and reaction B over here. In order to solve your reactions, could you do that? Okay, that was not difficult, but I'll just quickly repeat it. So if you want to solve the reactions, first thing you need to do is pin it at A and take moments about this point. So sum of the moments about point A equals 0, and clockwise moments equals positive. So in this case, if I pin it over here, I've got a 30 kN load for a distance of 2 meters. So 30 times 2, that's positive because it will rotate clockwise about this point. I've got another force here of 10 kN times 6 meters, also positive. I've got a 20 kN load times 2, 4, 6, 8 meters, also positive because it's rotating clockwise. And then 20 kN load times 10 meters. And that's also rotating clockwise about point A, so it's positive. And then lastly, second from last, is we've got a 5 kN UDL, 5 kN, spanning a distance of 4 meters, so you have to multiply that to 4, and then multiply it with the lever arm, so if you multiply that to a center pin load, it's 2 meters from R, or from A, so it is times 2. Okay, and then just lastly, that's also going to be positive. And lastly is my reaction at B. So the reaction at B will go anti-clockwise, rotate anti-clockwise about point A. So that is going to be reaction at B times a total distance of 12 meters. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 meters. And that's going to be negative because it's rotating anti-clockwise around that point. Okay, all of that equals 0. So in this case, my reaction at B, you will find your result, your reaction at B. In this case, your reaction at B was 43.3 kN. Okay, the same you would get if you rotated about point B. I'm not going to do this, this is part of your memo. So to get solve the reaction at A, you'll put it at B, and you repeat that same question. So in this case, we found the reaction at A to be 56.6 kN. And as soon as you get your answers, the first thing I do is I write it on my sketch so I don't make mistakes. So it's easy to write the wrong one, the wrong position. So the reaction at B is 43, so 43.3 kN. I write down here. And the reaction at A is 56.6. Okay, so that's on your sketch. As soon as that's done, you can start with your Bose notation. And your Bose notation, I'll just get a different color pen here. Your Bose notation is always, we always start to keep it uniform so that everyone gets the same answer. I always start left of my left hand side reaction. So it is at this point and we go clockwise all the way around my truss. So at point A, between this force and this force is going to be first point. So that's going to be point A or number A. So we always start from force to force. From this force to the next force is going to be point B. This force is going to be C. Between this force is going to be D. And then between these two forces, it's going to be E. F will be, okay, this is going to be a tricky one because what we do on UDLs, I take half of the load and I take it to this side and half the load to take it to that side. So in this case, it's 5 kilonewtons per meter for a distance of 4 meters. So 5 times 4 is 20 kilonewtons. Half of that will go to one side and half of that will go to the other side. So we divide a member into two pin loads. So in this case, 10 kilonewton will go to this side and another 10 kilonewton goes to this side. But what you don't do is when you start your numbering, there's no point A between these two points because it's only one force, a resultant force. So this resultant force at this point, you can either take this out, I'll keep it here for now, but there's 10 kilonewtons going down and 56.6 going up. So that means I've got the resultant of 46.6 going up at this point. So we have a resultant point at this, resultant force at this point here. Okay, so in other words, if I keep on going with my Bose notation, in between these two was D, these two forces was E, and then there is a new force here now. So it's in between these two forces, it's going to be F. And lastly, in between these two forces, add in G, and then I'm back at A. So we start at A, we're going all the way to G. In the inside, you just number your triangles. You can keep on going with your G's, but we do keep it inside 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it's easier to do that that way. So your Bose notation is normally about 2 marks, so 2 out of 20. You get some marks for that as well. If that's done, what you in effect have done is you've numbered your member. So this member will be called G1. This member here will be called 1, 2. This member here will be B2 and so on. So your task is now to determine if each member is in compression or in tension, and also what is the forces in your internal forces in the members. Okay. Let's take this off. So the first step was calculate your reactions, we've done that, then number your Bose notation, and then the third step is to do your load line. And that's where most of you make the mistakes. A load line is a line that represents all the forces in your member. So how we do this, and that's why we've done the Bose notation, is, and we've done it in between the forces. So we'll do the first force between A and B. So the first force go down 30 kilonewtons. So I'm going to use a simple scale on my one. You can use any scale you want, must fit on your page. So let's use a scale of 10 kilonewtons equals 10 millimeters on your page. So in that case means the first load between A and B goes downwards with a total of 30 kilonewtons, and 30 kilonewtons will equal to 30 millimeters on your page. So I'll start here on, I'll just make A here. I just want to see my demo quickly. This A is at the top. Okay, so in this case, I know A is at the top because I've done it before, so you just start here at the top, and we'll call this point A. So if we go from A to B, goes down with 30 kilonewtons. So you measure 30 millimeters going down. I'm just going to estimate anything here. Let's make that A to B. Okay, so that represents 30 millimeters. Okay, so then from B to C, I go down with another 10 millimeters because it's 10 kilonewtons. So I just want to subdivide this quickly. I go down with another 20 millimeters. 20 kilonewtons equals 20 millimeters into my scale. That's 10, 20. Okay, point D over here. From D to E, I go up with 43.3 millimeters. So that's 10. Take me up 10, 20, 30, 40, and a bit. So I'm just going to estimate that. So that's going to be point E. From E to F, I go down with 20 again. So that's 10, so that's 10, 20 millimeters. It's going to take me right here. So that's going to be point F. And then from F to G, I go down with 10 millimeters, another 10 kilonewtons. So I ignore the UDL, I take my pin load which I converted. So from F to G is 10 millimeters. So let's just make that again. That's about 10. F to G is 10 millimeters. And then from G back to A, it's not 56, it's the resultant here, that's 46. So 56.6 going upwards, 10 downwards, that gives me 46 going upwards. Okay, so from G, let's count 10 millimeter marks up, so G is 10. Take me right back to A. Okay, so it must balance. So your force is going upwards, must equal to your force going downwards, and then you've got a completed load line. Okay, I'm just going to draw it in here. So there's your load line. Okay, so what you do after you've done your load line is step number four. And step number four is you carry your members over to your load line. You draw your Cremona diagram or your Maxwell diagram. It's the same thing. Okay, so member A1 is going to be on a 45 degree angle. So what you do is you transfer this 45 degree angle to your load line and you look for a common numbers on them or a lettering on there. So this is going to be member A1. This is this member's name. Member A1 must be on your load line somewhere. So A1, I don't see a 1, but I see an A. So through A, we're going to draw a construction line on a 45 degree angle because this line is 45 degrees. So you just carry that line over to your sketch on a 45 degree angle. Estimating again, so my mind be a bit skewed. I'm going to try my best to make it balance. Okay, so you draw 45 degree construction line through there, and now you look for a common member here. A1 has got a 1 in common with G1, so the 1 is the common number here. So let's select member G1. So member G1 is on a 90 degree angle to on your forces. Over here, I've got a G over here. So from G, you draw a 90 degree angle going out here in this direction. It could be in any direction, so I draw it out in both directions. But where they cross, because this one is a common section here, that point there must be A1. So A1 and G1. Now most of you got that right in the task. So when you've got that point, you just make it the dark point, and I'll call that point number 1. That's a confirmed point. Okay, so we've covered member A1, we've covered member G1. Let's go for member 1-2. Because we've got the 1 here, I know the 1 will be somewhere on my sketch, but I don't know where the 2 is. So if I transfer the 45 degree angle I got on here to my sketch, and I use the 1 because the 1-2 is here, so 1 is a confirmed point, and I draw a 45 degree angle on here, that line is called line 1-2, but I don't know where the 2 is, so I look for a common member again. So in this case, B2. 2 is the common point if we're looking for point number 2 here. So B2 is again on a 90 degree angle to on my forces. So B2, B is over here, so I can just draw a 90 degree line from B to this direction. And where they cross over here, that must be point number 2. Okay, so 2 is confirmed. Let's go to member 2-3 then. Because we've got a 2 over here, to make it one nice and dark. From 2 to 3, 45 degree angle again. So we're using 2 because 2 was one of the nodes on my numbers. So you can just use it here for 45 degree line over here. Okay, you draw the 45 degree line. Again, there is no other point 3 on here, so it's not crossing everything. So we're looking for a common number 3, so it's F3. In this case, F3, it's on a 90 degree angle. So you just transfer it down, so you're looking for F. F is at this point here. So you're just transferring your down here. Draw a 90 degree line going out. And where they cross with line 2-3. 2-3 was this line, sorry, 2-3 was this line going out here. F3 is this line going out here. So where they cross is right at this point here. So that will be point number 3. So we confirm that, 2-3, yeah, F3. Okay, so you've got a point here. So point number 2 is over here, point number 3, point number 1. Okay, next step. We've covered 2-3, F3. So the next member we can use is number 3-4. Number 3-4 is at a 45 degree angle over here. So on 3-4, we've got a 3 already here. So you're transferring this 45 degree angle over here. And you transfer it to your sketch on a 45 degree angle. Okay, you guys are using graph paper, so it's quite easy to draw a 45 degree line. So now we've drawn line 3-4, let's draw 4C then. 4 is the common member here, 4C. So from point C, it's over here, draw a 90 degree line out from C. So C is right at this point, so I'm going to draw this out in this direction. And right here they will cross, that will be point number 4. So that's going to be point number 4. We've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 now on here. Next point, are you still with me? Okay, so now we've got C4 covered, we've got 3-4 covered, now we're looking for 4-5. 4-5 is in a 45 degree angle, we transfer it here to point number 4, and we draw a 45 degree angle on here, 45 degree line. 45 degree, that's going to be 0.45. Common member for 5 here is E5. So E5 is again 90 degrees, so you transfer this 90 degree line from E. So point E is over here. So this is Q1. Okay, so E5 was drawn. And 4-5 we said was the other, so 4-5 went through here, E5 was this one, and when that two lines cross from right over here, that's going to be point number 5. That's point number five. So we've got D5. So the last one we haven't covered now is D5. So D5 is on a 45-degree angle in this direction. So from 5, 45-degree line. And if you work accurate and you draw a 45-degree line, minus obviously not that accurate, it should end up right back at D. So D5 is going to be connected there. Okay, so we know we've worked accurate and we ended up back at D. So now you can complete your lines. So let's start at A1. Line A1. There's one and there's A. So let's make that the dark line so we can clearly see that. From A to 1, so that line there. From 1 to G, there's 1. G is over here, so you can just complete that line. So G1 is drawn. 1, 2, so the 45-degree angle, so from 1 to 2, just draw a line over here. From B to 2, so we've got the B here, there's 2, so you just complete that line. Okay, B2 done. 2, 3, 45-degree angle. 2, 2, 2.2 to 3. So that's that little short line over here. F3, 45-degree angle here. So we've got the 3, and all the way back to F. Same line over there. And then 3, 4, and from 3 to 4 is that little short line here. That line there, 3 to 4. Then we've got C to 4. C is over here, 4 is over here, so in that line. Okay, C4 is done. 4, 5, 45-degree angle, back to here, so from 4 all the way back to 2 is in the way, so I'll just move it out of the way. 4 to 5. Okay, and then lastly 5 to E and lead 5 to E. So 5 to E, we're in this direction, 5 back to D, and we're back to this direction. Okay, so that's your diagram. Okay, so that's your Maxwell diagram or your Cremona diagram. If you've drawn this, most of the work is done. Now, what most of you made a mistake is you've got to this point and you think you've got all your marks, but you've got no marks for this if you don't write your answers down. This is just a diagram. We need to write my answers down. So my answers, I need, the question was, what is the forces in member A1? And what is the nature of the force? So, for A1, you need to measure distance. So from A to 1, so on your Cremona diagram, from 1 to A, it's going to be this line. So I just want to get my distances right. So from A to, so that is about 10 millimeters, this distance here. So I'm just going to, you take your ruler and you measure A1. So in this case, I'm just going to estimate it. So it's going to be from 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Let's say 57 millimeters. 57 millimeters. If you go back to your scale, 57 millimeters will be how much kilonewtons. So in this case, 10 millimeters is 10 kilonewtons. In other words, 1 millimeter equals 1 kilonewton. So 1 kilonewton, so 57 millimeters will give you 57 kilonewtons. So I'm just going to compare it with my memory. That's a bit off. So according to your memo, okay, I'm just going to change it a bit. It's going to go at 62 millimeters, so that will be 62 kilonewtons according to the memo. Okay, then let's take any other member. I'm not going to do all of it, so let's take member 1, 2 for instance. So 1 is over here, 2 is over there. You measure that again, so 10, 20, it looks like 20 something millimeters. I've got here 24,
remember 1, 2 equals 24 millimeters. I'm just doing selected members, you have to do all the members. So you have member 1, 2 is 24 millimeters, that will equal to 24 kilonewtons. 24 kilonewtons. So what you do is you just carry on like this all the members. So I'm just going to do one more member. I'm going to select, let's make it member C4. So this is 4.4 ASC, so let's measure that quickly. So it's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, it looks like 80 millimeters. I've got here 68 millimeters, so C4, 60, and then again. So that will be 68 kilonewtons. Okay, so this is the actual force in that member, and now we need to see if it's in compression or in tension. Now, the biggest mistake people make here, they get the convention wrong. So how do we decide on the convention? I just draw two lines. If I compress this line, this member here, what is the reaction going to be in the member? If I press it, it wants to press back. In other words, that's the convention for compression. Okay, or a strut. The other member here, I will take and I will pull it out. So if I pull it back and out, it's going to try to pull back. So convention for tension. Look like this, or this other word for this is tie. So both of that is correct. I'm just going to use C and T. Compression and tension. Okay, so next to member A1, I need to determine if that is in compression or in tension. So the way we do this, and you have to be very careful now. Member A1 is this member here. What you do is you need to go to any one of these two nodes. So this member has got two nodes, and you can select any one of those. So in this case, I'm selecting this node here, and I'm drawing a line clockwise around this node. In this case, if I go clockwise around this node, I will carry on all the way from point 1, and I will cross it to A. So I will cross this member from 1 to A. It's like a hurdle. I'm just going to redraw A1 here. This is A, and this is 1. So if I run around the hurdle here, I'm jumping from A, from 1 to A. So I need to jump from the side of 1 to the side of A. So 1A, there's 1 here. A is in that side. So in other words, from 1 to A is in A, in that direction. Okay, so at this node, don't draw it anywhere. You have to draw it at that specific node. You draw arrow in that direction, same as on your Fremona diagram. Okay, and the opposite side of the member is going to be in the opposite direction. So if you look at this arrow, so it's going outwards. If it's going outwards, that's what means it's in compression, and all you need to do now is write a C behind it, compression. Okay, that's enough for me. That's, or you could write compression, or you could write the strut. Let's go to member 1, 2. In member 1, 2, member 1, 2 has got two nodes again. You can select any one of the two nodes. Draw clockwise. I'm selecting this one here, so I'm going clockwise around member 1, 2. So if I'm going clockwise around this node here, I will cross from 2 to 1 or 1 to 2. Question? Am I crossing from 1 to 2?
1 to 2.
1 to 2. Okay, good. So from 1 to 2 is in this direction. So at that specific node, draw an arrow in the same direction as on your Cremona diagram. You remove this. You don't need to draw a circle here, I'm just doing it for your purposes. So on the opposite side, the arrow will be in the opposite direction. If you look at this one, inwards arrows means tension. So just write T over here, that's enough, so it's in tension. Member C4 is this member here. Member C4 is from year to year. It's got two nodes. You can select any one. Let's select this node. So if I go clockwise around this node, I will cross from 4 to C. 4 to C. C is on this side, 4 is on this side. So I'm going to cross, if I go clockwise from C to 4 to C, C is over here, 4 is over here, so C to 4 is in this direction, sorry, 4 to C, yeah, it's in this direction. So 4 to C, same direction. And the opposite side, the opposite node will be in the opposite direction, so it's outward arrows, again, this is compression. Okay, so you repeat that for all your members, and when you finish your bet, you've got, I think the exam is 30 marks, you've got 25 out of 50 if you completed all of these answers. I will only spot mark about 6 of those, as in your memo. I'm not going to mark everyone, so I can mark any member here. So that's why it's important your Bowes notation must look the same as mine, because I'm going to look for member A1. Remember, A1 is going to be this one, and if you haven't started left off the left hand side reaction, your numbers is going to be scrambled up. Okay, now the other question is, check yourself with the mathematical calculations or the method of section. So on your diagram, there's already a section. This section is called section XX. So I'm going to try to do my calculation at the bottom. I'm not going to do all the calculations. One and two. So in this case, what you do is you can redraw this up. I'm going to do this on the next video perhaps. I'm just going to clean this up. I'll do this on the next video. Okay, I'm going to call it a bloody X now. Okay. I'm just going to give you some. Okay, so what you do there, there's no money to be off, you can get up the copy, you can get the sticker.